I'm Zachary Fowler, and this is 10 Things to Do While Stuck at Home, brought to you by SimpliSafe. Oh!
First shot!
Sweet! Yes! I'm Zachary Fowler, and you're watching Fowler's Makery and Mischief. Who is it?
Pizza delivery for Mr. Fowler.
Leave it on the doorstep.
You have to pay for it, Mr. Fowler.
How much is it? It's $11.88. Step back by your car so you can see me from the upper window.
Okay.
Cheapskate.
All right, my pineapple and anchovy pizza. Pineapple and anchovies. All silliness aside, my hopes and prayers go out to you and your families during this time of the pandemic, and we hope that you find some chances to have fun during this. And that's why we came up with this list of 10 fun things to do while being stuck at home. So, let's get right into it, starting off number 10, blowguns. Alright, I got a couple different kinds of blowguns here in my collection. We got the cold steel blowguns, which are a larger bore diameter. That's what we're going to use today right now. And then we got the smaller ones, which are great for kids. My kids aren't old enough yet to be able to shoot a slingshot. They get frustrated with it, so they end up quitting before we even get started practicing and playing with those. So I let my daughters use the small blowgun here, the small diameter. They're able to shoot darts with it and just as accurately as I could shoot my slingshot at times. So it's really fun for them, and I recommend this. And they're the cheapest ones you could possibly get on Amazon. You can also build your own blowgun just with a piece of electrical conduit and some electrical connectors and some sheetrock screws. But we'll take these big bore blowguns out. Tim Wells has actually even taken a bear with these, so they're not just a toy. You can do quite a bit with this. The quickest way I've found to build a target for a blowgun is simply a cardboard box of any sort and some sort of rags inside to stop the darts from keep going like all the way through and out the other side. Just make sure whatever rags you're using, old sleeping bags, you don't mind if they get a little bit of punctures and holes in them, because they will if you keep shooting it for a while. All right, we're all set up. About 25 feet's your good distance for a blowgun, a little less than 20 for kids, 15 to 20, and you know, you can go up to about 30, 35, but then the arc is a little higher, it's not as fun. And just like anything else, it's more fun if you're doing it with a friend. So we got Brandon here, a little competition. It's always fun. And maybe have two blowguns, because if you are doing it with a friend, you don't want to be swapping spit on the same blowgun.
Especially in these days, you know? Stay back.
So let's see. First to take down the squirrel wins.
I like it.
And then we'll take out the clown. The
squirrel first.
All right, see what we got going on. Oh, that's awful.
Oh. it's been a couple minutes.
My blowgun skills are rusty. Well, I guess we're gonna shoot one round and then we gotta sanitize the blow darts.
We're gonna have to. Yeah, just... I don't wanna get your dart. I didn't label mine either.
And this is why blowgun is number 10 on our list, because unless you're doing it with a spouse, You might want to label your dart so you're not sucking on the same dart as the person next to you. So we're shooting one round of these and then we're done and on to the next thing on the list.
Oh, there it is.
There it is. That's a squirrel. Look at that grouping. Beautiful grouping. That is one hurting clown.
And number 9, reading. No better time than the present to catch up on that reading you keep saying you're going to do. And my number 1 pick, of course, is the Bible every day with the Our Daily Bread app to assist my reading. Witchery of Archery, a book written in the 1800s, epic adventures of an archer. The Complete Angler, I haven't read it, but I hear it's the same as The Witchery of Archery, just really epic old book. Lords of the Bow, it's a historical fiction about Genghis Khan and about how their design of the bow gave them supremacy over everybody they came up against and how they were able to take over almost the whole world at the time. Wheel of Time series by Robert Jordan, maybe the best fantasy series outside of the Chronicles of Narnia, which is a definite must family read. Going Home by A. American, a fiction work about societal collapse that is just chocked full of educational bits about survival. The Forgotten Arts, this is a must-have book in your library if you are at all interested in building or making things, and just a smart prep should we find ourselves in a more primitive days. And of course, in that same vein of thought is books on wild edibles. I've linked all these books in my Amazon store, linked in the description below. Wild edible plants, you pretty much have to go on Amazon and find one that matches your area. Take it with you on hikes or just look for treasure in your backyard. You'll never know what you find.
And number 8, the Daisy Red Rider BB gun. That's a classic right there. This is what got me into marksmanship and wanting to plink away at things. I made a box, or my dad and I made a box for plinking away, and all of my G.I. Joe guys got destroyed because of one of these BB guns. I shot every single one of them to pieces, and not just like just randomly. I'd shoot off like one hand. It was like Sid from Toy Story.
And I can have a cookout later.
You spelt my name wrong.
Did I really?
Yeah. That's a Z-A-C-H, not Z-A-C-K.
Oh, this is awkward.
Well, the beauty of having this little low-powered BB gun is if you got a basement and things like that, you can plink away at a simple box like this and a pile of cardboard with some rags inside, just like the blowgun darts. I would still wear glasses if you're inside of a basement with cement walls as your backdrop. Add a blanket or something first. Old sleeping bags work great for all this stuff. Let's have a little competition. We got a little battleship target we printed up off the internet. All right, heads I win, tails you lose.
All right, perfect.
All right, call it in there.
All right, tails.
Oh, you get to go first.
All right.
Or you get to let me go first. It's up to you.
You go first.
What, really?
Yeah, I want to make this. I want to give you a chance.
So for those of you who want to leave it in the comments below about how we're not social distancing, we work every day in the same office. Together, we've kind of resigned to the fact that if one person gets sick, they all get sick, just like your kids bring home all those wonderful things from school. We're gonna go 3 for 3 and see whose ships are sunk first. Wow, those are really tiny targets.
I was just thinking that. I'm like, can you see that?
At this distance, they like all of a sudden like got really tiny. All right, revising the plan, the targets are just too hard to hit with this thing. Ha! There we go.
38 seconds.
38 seconds? That's, I feel like, bad. I had like 3 duds in there.
Yeah, there was three definitely duds. At least 3 or 4.
You think your Call of Duty score is going to help you out
here? I think it's going to help. I think it's going to help a little bit.
We'll see. On your mark, get set, go.
Oh, take 2. Hold
on. Oh, it didn't go over. Ripped off. Duds. Oh. Clearly there's some flaws.
No.
There's some, no, more, mostly declare some flaws into our competitive gaming strategy. Making it,
that was a workout.
Making it not so fair, but I think there's some potential there.
Let's move on to the next thing.
And number 7, carving. If you've been watching my videos for any period of time, you're always seeing me carve stuff from a set of chopsticks so I can eat my meal to an entire chess set so I can have some fun when I'm spending some time out in the woods with my buddy. Amazon is full of books on carving, as well as YouTube having tons of videos on carving. You can look those up there. I don't usually get too informative with my carving videos. And that reminds me, I recommend highly that you get YouTube Red. Should we ever lose the internet, God forbid, YouTube Red allows you to, while we still have the internet, download videos. So you could download videos on canning, download videos on how to carve, how to do any number of things. And then should you ever find yourself in a grid down situation where we don't have the internet, you could still access those videos on your phone as long as you still had a charge to that phone. And for more inspiration on carving, check out Marling Bates on YouTube. He's one of my favorites. I love watching his one day build and catch. And number 6, the sling. This is a clip from my old video. I'll link it below. Slingshot versus sling. And it is so easy to build. Just a solid piece of string, shoelace, something like that, and a scrap of leather. Or you get a bit fancier and you go ahead and weave yourself one. And then there is the staff sling, which gives you the chance to become accurate in a matter of seconds hitting a 2-foot target. But the real beauty of a traditional sling is it fits in your back pocket, goes on hikes, or whatever. And now a quick word about our sponsor for this video before we go over the last 5.
Oh. Those do not go together. That's not a combination. That's not, no. That's not gonna, never.
Oh. Anyway, SimpliSafe, our sponsor, reached out to me last month and said, would you like to do a sponsored video? We think this would be a good fit for you. You going away on long, protracted adventures, what do you do to protect your home? Because when you go away for long things, what do? You either lock your doors and hope that everything is just the way you left it when you come home, or you have a house sitter.
Hey, welcome to the show. My guests today say love is a dirty game, and they are not afraid to let things get messy. Please meet Sarah. She's back to get the man she wants. Sarah, what's going on?
Well, Jerry, you know, you guys are like family to me. Hi, how you doing, Todd? Hey, Richard, how you guys today?
Something's always gonna, you're gonna come back and you're gonna find weird things. Like, look at this. This was my old apprentice. I come back and he says, by the way, yeah, there's a couple holes in the window. Now, yeah, I shoot a slingshot all around my house all the time and make all kinds of messes. But it's another thing when you come home and you find Cheetos rubbed into your couch because your house sitter's been having himself a good old time because it's not his couch. So SimpliSafe said they could set me up with a home system that was simple, I could install it, and they sent it over, and we installed it. I meant to actually film the installation of this, but it went so fast, so I was like, I'm just gonna put one or two of these things up. Now, with SimpliSafe, you have all kinds of different options, multiple packages that you can choose from. I think the lowest one starts at about $200-something, comes with your home unit, your keypad here, and then you can get all the different things to go along with it. For just $15 a month, they will monitor my systems, and if the alarm goes off, they'll notify the police, which some of these systems are. I got door sensors here, motion sensors here. I even have a sensor underneath the sink and over by the washer, so that if the pipes freeze and break and water starts running out, I got a water sensor here. And then there's a temperature sensor. I can't remember where I put that one, actually. And then motion sensor in the hallway up here. So we have sensors all over the place for different things. Oh, and even over here in the corner, there is a glass breaking sensor, as well as sensors on the windows.
And of course, my favorite, the video doorbell. If you have to social distance, do it with style.
So between all that stuff working together and the temperature sensors and the water sensors, if something happens, for just $15 a month, they will notify the police. And for $29 a month, my cameras, my doorbell cameras and my interior cameras will have a continuous recording loop so that if we ever catch something silly happening in the kitchen or a weird encounter where somebody comes to the door and decides to get pushy, I'll have it all on film here and be a little bit more secure. All of this can be monitored from your app on your phone. I can unlock the door with my phone. As long as you have a dedicated deadbolt on your door, their system bolts right up to it, and the sticky pad, number pad, goes right on the outside here. Can't look at this, can't see my code. I gotta look at it though. Did I get it? Oh, I did.
Simply Safe on. Home.
And your entire system is monitored through the Simply Safe little tower here, which is connected to your Wi-Fi. It was really easy to set up. And I like this because all those little door chimes and things when I am home and I put it on off.
Alarm off.
If somebody goes through the door and it chimes, I know that somebody's here and I can take a peek out and I can just be like, oh, it's UPS and they're dropping stuff off in the sunroom. So with the home hub piece of it all integrating and connecting everything, there's even a panic button, which I installed under the desk. I don't see myself ever needing that, but...
What do you mean? There's a legal issue with my trap door. And as you explain, please take two steps back.
The old trap door was perfectly legal.
It has to be handicap accessible. A wheelchair would never fall through the current opening.
You know, I feel like if somebody were to break in, they would have to set off at least two, or if not three, of the sensors to mess around with stuff here. They'd have to set off the motion sensors, they'd have to set off one of the door sensors, and if they didn't set off the door sensors or whatever, they'd break the glass, and then they'd set off the motion sensors, and the cops would be called, or the alarm's going off, and they're already hitting the road before they've even grabbed anything. And if they do grab something, then the cameras have recorded, and I know that Simply Safe has got my back. So let's get on with it. The rest of the video here, we got five more fun things to do while you're stuck at home. And number five, gardening slash yard beautification, I guess. I built this last year and it is such a cool little area. There was just some logs I had laying around up at the land. Some, these were actually came from across the street that before I bought the place, the neighbor had milled these and made some planks. And that's what my kitchen counter is actually made out of. These ones were laying around outside, so they're half rotten. I took the nice pieces of them, made the fire pit. And this is the garden that came with the place. I haven't gardened in a number of years since we re-grid from leaving the yurt, off-gridding, and moving here. When we lived off-grid in the yurt, we grew enough tomatoes with 24 tomato plants that we could can enough tomatoes to have one pasta meal a week and then have enough sauce left to do one pizza a week for the family. And that was just 24 tomato plants, a bunch of carrots to use instead of sugar in making your tomato sauce, some peppers and onions and all the herbs and spices, the kind of oregano, basil, parsley type spices, and rosemary. And we made the most delicious tomato sauce, except for the couple batches I burnt in the canner. But I'm gonna go out and get some more materials. We're gonna do some digging in the yard this summer to trench it so it doesn't stay all muddy like this. And then I'll have a beautiful, beautiful garden right here and food to be able to prepare at home without having to go out to the grocery store. So yeah.
And number four, fishing. It kept me alive for 87 days and won me $500,000 on History Channel's Alone Show Season 3.
You won. You won. We can go home.
For reals. For real. This is unbelievable.
Definitely the top three must-have survival skills to be able to fish with minimal gear and catch enough to provide for yourself. So you can go as crazy as printing your own lures on a 3D printer just for the fun of it, or you can go as minimal as I did in Patagonia with catching all those fish just on hooks, grubs, and worms that I found in the earth. I'll link three videos in the description below that you can watch to inspire you to challenge yourself on your next fishing adventure.
First ingredient. A good stew, some butter, just toss that in there.
Number three, cooking. Perhaps you're not very good at cooking. You've never really taken the time to get good at it. You just keep making the same mistakes. like not taking the package off. Well, you can learn to cook now. You got the time. Or perhaps you've been hearing me talk about the ketogenic diet and you're ready to take the plunge. The best way to succeed at that is to spend enough time learning new recipes so that you're not finding yourself hungry and tempted to go back to carbs. Not to mention, cooking is a great way to creatively combine some of the earlier activities we talked about, like fishing or gardening. And especially our last, or second to last here, number two, hiking. Hiking is a great way to go out and do something in the outdoors. It's safe, and instead of just hiking up to see a view, hike for a purpose. Look for something to carve. Look for something to cook. Do some foraging. Come back with something to add to your dinner table. You never know what you might find when you step out that door to explore the world around you.
And finally, my number one pick of fun things to do while you're stuck at home, slingshots. You can go down the rabbit hole as deep as you want to go. I've got some really expensive slingshots. I've got some production slingshots, simple shot that you may have seen me out there hunting with during my survival challenge, the recent one, 30-day survival challenge, Canadian Rockies, and they operate excellent. But my favorite slingshot is one that I carved to fit my hand, and I took sixth place in the East Coast Slingshot Tournament 2 years ago, and then second place this last year with it. If you practice with it enough, you can become good with it. It doesn't take much to build a shooting range. You can have a simple curtain, and this is another loop curtain right here so that the ammo that hits this curtain ends up in there and we can collect it back out of there. Or you can go as simple as a cardboard box, stuffing an old sleeping bag in it, just like we were doing for the darts. And you can tie a rope to these, putting some cool paper targets on it, hang it from the tree. Let's go head out in the yard and I'll show you some more fun stuff. Ugh, it's muddy out here. There's our outdoor range. Pretty much the same as our indoor range. It's just a little bit bigger backdrop and catch area. Fun thing about the outdoor range is we can add spoons onto here. The ammo tends to ricochet a little further off of it, always behind the target range, so it's safe enough. But you can add things that clang, things like cans. You can hang cans from here. And one of my favorite new targets, the little pheasant head here. And the beauty of this is you can put it anywhere you want. And that's one of the my favorite things about slingshots, is because the ammo doesn't cost a fortune. When you lose an arrow, you're like, ah, that, darn it. You know, that cost me some wages. But with slingshot ammo, you get it in bulk. And so you can afford to do wild shots. So we're gonna take this, throw this around, and do some wild shooting, waste some ammo. We'll play a game of pig. Yeah, just like with basketball, you throw your target, whether it's a can, and then you pick a spot to shoot it from. If the person who calls the shot hits it, they get the other person has to match that shot or they get a letter.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. I'll let you go first and make the first call.
All right.
Since I got to go first last time. You're gonna take it easy on me, picking a 20-foot distance to start.
I gotta give you a little leeway.
Oh,
look at that.
Got it on three. So what, if you get three shots, then what do I get?
You get two.
I get two?
Okay. Yeah.
All right, that's fair enough. So I spotted you one, basically.
You spotted me one, yes.
Okay.
Oh, of course.
Do I get points? Do they roll over
no,
to my next turn?
That's the end of your turn.
All right, but you get to pick a new spot for the target.
How far back are you going to go?
Right here.
That's like, that's a good 33 feet.
I'm warmed up now, so. Oh, that nicked it. Does that count?
Did you hit it?
I nicked it.
It didn't move. I didn't see it move.
Oh, it moved. The GoPro got it.
Oh, that nicked it. Does that count? The fans are watching.
I missed. Getting cocky and I go and miss.
Oh, there we go. There it is.
Pheasant on the burn pile. All right, pheasant on the burn pile, huh? You just jinxed yourself, didn't you? This one's too easy, he says. Oh, ooh. Nailed it.
All right, ready?
Ready.
Oh.
First shot.
We gotta move back.
Yeah, we gotta start going. You gotta pick a longer shot.
I know, I'm still warming up.
I know you don't want to miss, but like, if you don't pick a longer shot, you're never gonna throw me off my game. Unfortunately, that wasn't supposed to be the end of the video, but it is. We found out that evening that the governor was declaring a lockdown on the state of Maine, so we moved all of our shipping facilities so Brandon can ship from home, and I'm here editing alone. My two guys are all working from home now, so we're ending the video there. For more Slingshot resources, check out the link in the description below for my How to Shoot a Slingshot video. There's also a link down there for the Slingshot Mastery Course, which is a very extensive course that goes way beyond what my How to Shoot a Slingshot video has, and I'm going to be doing some courses with them. And there's a new free one we're putting together right now, which will be out in a couple of days, if not right now, depending on when you're watching the video, called The Joy of Slingshot Shooting. Am I getting that right? Yeah, The Joy of Slingshots. And since Maine is doing this whole lockdown thing, I decided to do season 3 of the 30-day survival challenge right here at home. I've been filming for it while finishing the edit on this, and that'll be available April 10th, Friday evening at 9 p.m. I think will be the first episode, 30-day survival challenge right here at home. It'll be very different than anything I've ever done before because we're going to be posting new episodes every single day. Check out those links in the description below. I put little links and or places to answer any of your questions for each of the 10 things down below, and a link especially right at the top for our sponsor, SimpleSafe. Thank you guys very much for sponsoring this video, and thank you guys for watching. See you next time. Fowler out.